Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Please be seated. The people of God and the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit. In baptism, the whole church is summoned to witness to God's saving love in Christ and to pray for the coming of his kingdom. God forms us in Christ into a royal priesthood, a holy nation, to declare the wonderful deeds of him who has called us out of darkness into his marvellous light. To serve this royal priesthood, God has given particular ministries. Presbyters are ordained to lead God's people in the offering of praise and the proclamation of the gospel, and share with the bishop in the oversight of the church. They are to set the example of the Good Shepherd always before them as the pattern of their calling. With the bishop and their fellow presbyters, they are to sustain the community of the faithful by the ministry of word and sacrament, that we may all grow into the fullness of Christ and be a living sacrifice acceptable to God. Presbyter,
I do so believe.
Let us pray.
The Holy Gospel is written in that according to St. Matthew in the 20th chapter, beginning at the 20th verse.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Then the mother of the sons of Zebedee came up to him with her sons, and kneeling before him, she asked him for something. And he said to her, "What do you want?" She said to him, "Say that these two sons of mine are to sit one at your right hand and one at your left in your kingdom." Jesus answered, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I am to drink?" They said to him, "We are able." He said to them, "You will drink my cup. But to sit at my right hand and at my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it hath been prepared by my Father." And when the ten heard it, they were indignant at the two brothers. But Jesus called them to him and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones exercise authority over them. It shall not be so among you, but whoever would be great among you must be your servant, and whoever would be the first among you must be your slave, even as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. Today is St. James's Day. Now, there are two St. James's in the New Testament. One is James, the half-brother of Jesus. And he becomes the leader of the church in Jerusalem, and we read about him in, say, Acts 15. And there's a book named after him in the New Testament, the letter of James. But today's James isn't that one. The James whom we remember and honour today is the one that you've just heard about in the reading, the brother of John, James and John. So what do we know about him? How does he relate to Stephen's ordination today? Well, the first mention of James that we have is in St. Mark's Gospel, chapter 1. Passing alongside the Sea of Galilee, Jesus saw Simon and Andrew, the brother of Simon, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." And immediately they left their nets in, and you have heard his declaration. Is it now your will that he should be ordained?
It is.
Will you continually pray for him?
We will.
Will you uphold and encourage him in his ministry?
We will.
In the name of our Lord, we bid you remember the greatness of the trust that is now to be committed to your charge. Remember always with thanksgiving that the treasure now to be entrusted to you is Christ the shedding of his blood on the cross. It is to him that you will render account for your stewardship of his people. You cannot bear the weight of this calling in your own strength, but only by the grace and power of God. Pray, therefore, that your heart may daily be enlarged and your understanding of the Scriptures enlightened. The divine grace, which heals that which is infirm and supplies what is lacking, calls the deacon Stephen to the ministry of presbyter. Let us pray, therefore, that the grace of the Holy Spirit may come upon him. And we come now to a period of prayer. Please, in addition to the prayers on the sheet, as it were, add in your hearts your own silent prayers for Stephen. There will be a short time of silent prayer. Then we will sing a prayer, the one that's on the top of page 13, called the Come Holy Ghost. That's a sung prayer. And then there's a long, what's called a litany, a prayer where Tom will be leading it and we respond to each section. And then there's finally the ordination prayer where Tom and I will lay hands on Stephen. So quite a long period of prayer, because this is a very, very special occasion. So let's bow our heads on the earth.
Say together the litany, the other bottom of page 13. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Lord, O God, the Father of heaven.
Have mercy upon us, miserable sinners.
O God, the Son, Redeemer of the world.
Have mercy upon us, miserable sinners.
O God, the Holy Ghost, proceeding from the Father.
Have mercy upon us, miserable sinners.
O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, three persons and one God.
Have mercy upon us, miserable sinners.
We sinners do beseech thee to hear us, O Lord God, and that it may please thee to rule and govern thy holy church, universal in the right way.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to illumine John, our bishop, and all bishops, presbyters, and deacons, with true knowledge and understanding of thy word, and that both by their preaching and living they may set it forth and show it accordingly.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it please thee to bless this thy servant, Stephen, now to be ordained presbyter, and to pour thy grace upon him to the edifying of thy church and the glory of thy holy name.
We beseech thee to hear us,
that it may please thee to bless and keep all thy people.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to give to all thy people increase of grace, to hear meekly thy word, and to receive it with pure affection, to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to strengthen such as do stand, and to comfort and help the weak-hearted, and to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to succour, help, and comfort all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sins, negligences, and ignorances, and to endure us with the grace of thy Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to thy holy word.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
Remembering all who have gone before us in faith, and in communion with all the saints, we commit ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ, our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Apostle and High Priest of our faith, and the Shepherd of our souls. So now send down the Holy Spirit on your servant Stephen, for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Grant him grace and power to proclaim the gospel of your salvation and minister the sacraments of the new covenant. Renew him in holiness, and give him wisdom and discipline to work faithfully with those committed to his charge. May he be diligent in working with his bishop, fellow presbyters, and all the faithful in Christ, to reconcile what is divided, to heal what is wounded, and to restore what is lost. May he declare your blessings to your people. May he proclaim Christ's victory over the powers of darkness, and absolve in Christ's name those who turn to your Son in faith. So shall a people made whole in Christ offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to you, our God and Father, whom with the Son and the Holy Spirit belong glory and honour, worship and praise, now and forever.
Amen.
Even may God, to whose service prophets, priests, and kings were anointed, strengthen you to fulfill the ministry now laid upon you. Even take authority to preach the word of God and to minister the sacraments in the congregation to which you shall be.